Now we had found out our cos theta as this, so I have left it on the board as it was, and I'll now try to find out what the sine theta is. Okay, so my sine theta is equal to 1 minus cos square theta root over. So that is root over 1 minus square of this will make it a1 a2 plus b1 b2 plus c1 c2 whole squared divided by the square of this will take away the root sign from both of them, correct? So it will give us a1 square plus b1 square plus c1 square into correct. Okay, so now that gives me root over it will yield 9 terms, right? So it will give you a1 square, a2 square, plus a1 square, b2 square, plus a1 square, c2 square, plus b1 square, a2 square, plus b1 square, b2 square. Plus b1 square, c2 square, plus c1 square, a2 square, plus c1 square, b2 square. Plus c1 square c2 square minus a1 a2 plus b1 b2 plus c1 c2 whole squared is what? X plus y plus z whole square is what? You remember? X plus y plus z whole squared is x square plus y square plus z square plus 2xy plus 2yz plus 2zx. It's pretty cyclical, okay? So it is minus a1 square a2 square plus b1 square b2 square plus c1 square c2 square, okay? Plus 2a1 a2 b1 b2 plus 2b1 b2 c1 c2 plus 2c1 c2 a1 a2. Minus, okay, this divided by this, looks pretty threatening, but you'll soon find it will fall into a pattern after getting cancelled, okay. So what happens, my a1 square a2 square cancels this and b1 square b2 square cancels this and c1 square c2 square cancels this. So that is 6 terms gone. Now I am left with a1 b2. See, a1 square b2 square, I'll just club one of them for you. a1 square b2 square and then b1 square a2 square and this. I'll mark it with green. So look at the green ones, this and this, okay. There is a negative here, so this is actually negative, okay. It looks like positive, but after opening the bracket it will become negative. So can I write it as a1 b2 minus a2 b1 whole square? I can, okay. And If I clubbed this jagged ones, a1 c2 square, c1 a2 square and this, together they'll give you what? a1 c2 minus a2 c1 whole square. Do they give that?
Yes.
Meaning you should actually, you're free to speak. Okay, so, and then बी वन सी टू सी वन बी टू एंड दिस ठीक है दे गिव यू दे गिव यू बी वन सी टू माइनस बी टू सी वन होल स्क्वायर राइट वाई बिकॉज स्क्वायर ऑफ दिस गिव्स यू बी वन स्क्वायर सी टू स्क्वायर बी टू स्क्वायर सी वन स्क्वायर प्लस एंड माइनस टू बी वन बी टू सी वन सी टू यू विल गेट फ्रॉम देयर राइट सो दैट डिवाइडेड बाई divided by a1 square plus b1 square plus c1 square into a2 square plus b2 square plus c2 square that ओके सो साइन थीटा इज दिस एंड इट्स अ ह्यूमंगस काइंड ऑफ एक्सप्रेशन दैट यू विल फाइंड राइट सो साइन थीटा इज ए वन बी टू माइनस ए टू बी वन होल स्क्वायर प्लस आई प्रेफर टू राइट दिस फर्स्ट राइट सो बी वन सी टू माइनस बी टू सी वन होल स्क्वायर प्लस ए वन सी टू माइनस सी टू ए वन होल स्क्वायर अपॉन ए वन स्क्वायर प्लस बी वन स्क्वायर प्लस सी वन स्क्वायर ए टू स्क्वायर प्लस बी टू स्क्वायर प्लस सी टू स्क्वायर रूट ओवर नाउ दिस लुक्स टू बी अ वेरी सिंपल थिंग compared to this still why would we go for that okay we'll go for that for a simple reason that will become very clear to you right now now you see if the lines are perpendicular okay if the lines are perpendicular then what happens theta is equal to 90 degree obviously
theta is equal to 90 degree
so this will be zero okay for this to be zero this cannot be zero right because they are non zero vectors they have some length so the numerator of this has to be zero
that is cos theta is equal to zero
so from I'll say this is 1 and I'll say this is 2 this whole thing is 2 okay so therefore from 1 we have what do we have the numerator goes to 0 so a1 a2 plus b1 b2 plus c1 c2 is equal to 0 That means the dot product of the vectors has to be zero, correct?
That is B1 dot B2 is equal to zero.
Okay, so both are equivalent. Okay. Now what if the lines are parallel? If the lines are parallel, what happens? Sine theta becomes zero. No? Theta is equal to zero. It implies that sine theta is equal to zero. Now there is an interesting thing and this you should keep in mind even for some future other problems. This is composed of sum of the squares.
okay. Now squares are always positive, fine. Now if I want sin theta to be 0, it means the numerator of this has to be 0. This cannot be 0, we have been already saying, right? Because these are non-zero vectors, they have some length, so they'll never go to 0 because they represent the length. So this has to be 0. Now when can the sum of three positive numbers become 0? Never ever, okay. For that, these individual terms have to be 0. Do you get that? So these individual terms have to be 0 if you want this whole numerator to be 0. So then I write implies sin theta is equal to 0. That is a1 b2 minus a2 b1 is equal to 0. Okay, b1 c2 minus b2 c1 is equal to 0. a1 c2 minus c2 a1 is equal to 0. Okay. Now when is that possible? That tells me that a1 upon a2 is equal to b1 upon b2. Do we get that? And this gives me b1 upon b2 is equal to c1 upon c2. And this gives me a1 c2 minus, this is not a1 c2 minus c2 a1. This is a1 c2 minus c1 a2, okay? c1 a2. This is c1 a2, okay? Because they were becoming identical terms. a1 c2 minus c1 a2, okay? c1 a2. Mind that correction. So I get a1 upon a2 is equal to c1 upon c2. What do they tell me? They tell me that a1 upon a2 is equal to b1 upon b2 is equal to c1 upon c2. That is, the direction ratios are proportional. This we had done by some other method yesterday as well, if you remember. Do you remember that?
Yes,
sir. We had done it through vectors. So these become a very, very important thing to understand. This we have done in vectors as well. But again, we are doing it in straight lines. Okay? 3D. We are right now dealing lines in space, right? We'll now do an example before we move ahead.